little yogi friends. I wanted to bring a little kids yoga to you from your homes. I work at the DRC and I teach some classes and I work with some kids at my school and we have a yoga club. And then I also teach kids yoga at a couple other places. So today we're going to read the book Rachael's Day in the Garden. And I tried doing it outside, but my microphone didn't work very well. So in my house, I'm going to have to talk pretty loud too. And you might see a little dog that's sitting back there in the chair. He likes to hang out. I couldn't get him to go anywhere else but his chair. So Rachael's Day in the Garden. And we're going to do a little bit of yoga with it while I read it to you. We always start yoga, though, by just sitting down and getting out some of our wiggles and our creaks and things from, especially if you just woke up this morning. So we're going to sit back down on our mat. You can sit however you are comfortable. And I just want you to take a couple rolls of your shoulders, front and back, and roll your neck one way and the other way. So that's where we can get some of those creaks out in the morning. Another thing that I like to do is take a twist. And when you take a twist, you're going to put one leg or one hand on your opposite leg, take the other hand behind you, and just slowly look over your shoulder. So one more time. When we twist, it's opposite hand to opposite knee, hand behind you, and then you slowly twist. You don't just yank yourself back. So slowly twist yourself around. And then let's take a couple minutes here on the floor to get our breath. And what that means is we all breathe every day, but we don't think about taking really good deep breaths. So we're going to take a really good deep breath, and we're going to start by just breathing in for three. So breathe in and breathe out. And breathe in. And breathe out. So however long it took you to take the breath in, take that long to take the breath out. So now let's go for five. So breathe in. And breathe out. And breathe in. And breathe out. Awesome. And a lot of times we do some other stretches and some other things, but I just wanted to kind of make this a short one for you today. So when you wake up in the morning, do whatever stretches that you need to do to wake your body up. And we are going to read Rachael's Day in the Garden. So I'm going to try and stand right here, and I'll read it to you. Rachael sees a lot of colors in her garden. So as we're reading it, think about the colors that she sees and where you might see those colors every day. Hopefully you're getting to go outside and see things. So when she starts her day, and I'm going to read through a couple pages actually in the beginning so that we can do a couple poses in a row. So Rachael, when she wakes up in the morning, she says, "Good morning, world." And as she says this, she looks out the window and the sun is shining on her and the sun is yellow. And she has her little dog back there, like I have my dog back there. Her dog's name is Sammy. So she says hello to the sun. Then when they go outside in a little bit after she hugs her dog Sammy, because you always got to say hello to your dog in the morning, they go outside and it's raining. And when they're outside and it's raining, they skip around the backyard, and then she falls down and touches her toes like the rain that's falling. So we're going to do those two poses together, saying hello to the sun and the rain falling, and we're going to combine it with the pose we're going to see later in the book, where she's a caterpillar and she's down on the ground. So we're going to do all three poses, and this is our sun A that we do when you do yoga with me or when you do yoga with other people. If your mommies or daddies do yoga, that is something we do at the beginning of our practice. And with my little kids, we call it saying hello to the sun. So listen to me. We're going to go through it, and I'll do two of them, okay? So you step up to the top of your mat, and we start by breathing up and reaching our hands up high, saying hello to the sun. Then we let that rain fall and we touch our toes. Come part way up, make your back flat, and then go all the way down. Now the next part is where we are going to step back and lay on our bellies and be that caterpillar. So our hands are down, our feet are back, we're in a plank, and we're going to drop our bellies to the floor. And this is where you're a caterpillar. And you just kind of lift your head up just a little bit
and then put it back down.
Then you're going to push back up into the plank, push your bottom up, and we call this a down dog. So like Sammy, her dog, this is a down dog. And you can walk your legs like you're walking your dog. Then step your hands up, come halfway up, go all the way down, come all the way up, bring your hands to your heart. That was one sun A. We're going to do one more. So breathe up, let the rain fall down, come partway up, all the way down, put your hands down, put your feet back, drop to your belly, and be that caterpillar, and reach your head up, and lay it back down, and then push yourself up, up to a down dog, and this time, jump your feet to your hands, and then come halfway up, all the way down, all the way up, and bring your hands to your heart. So we just did two sun A's, and we helped Rachael say hello to the sun. So when we left her, her and Sammy were looking at the rain, and the rain was blue. The sun was yellow, the rain was blue. So those are two colors to think about today. The next thing they did is they went and they stood under a tree. There are lots of trees right now, and those trees are starting to bloom. They're not big and green like this yet. So we're going to do our tree pose. In our tree pose, and I won't go all the way back to my mat, I'll go right here. Maybe I'll go back a little bit so you can see me. So in a tree pose, your one leg is your trunk. Okay, so you decide which leg is your strong leg. Then your bottom, your other leg can be here, here, or way up here. Never put it on your knee because we don't want to hurt our knees. Our knees are important. They help us bend. So I'm going to put mine up here. Make sure your trunk is good and strong and put your branches up. And you can have your branches up however you want. You can have them falling down, one falling down, up here. And then if we do one side, we have to do the other side. So go ahead and do the other side. Like this. Good job. See how long you can hold it. Maybe even the hardest thing to do is to close your eyes when you do a tree. We've tried that in my class. Lots of people have a hard time with that. So, she's a tree. Trees are green. The next thing she does is she leans forward to listen to the birds. And this position is called a warrior three pose. So we're going to do this, but for me, to get to a warrior three, you have to start with a warrior one. So, we're going to get into warrior one, kind of different than we usually do. But you have one leg forward, one leg back, your back foot, your foot's turned in just a little bit. I'm going to turn my little camera help just a little bit. Okay, so you can maybe see better my feet. So you have one foot forward. The back foot is turned just a little bit. Your hips are facing forward like this. And you put your arms up straight because you're a warrior. So this is warrior one. Warrior three, like Rachael, when she's out in the garden listening, you lean forward and see if you can balance that way. And if you can't, that's okay. Just do as long as you can. Come back down. We're going to do it on the other side. So again, front foot, toes facing forward. Back foot, turn just a little bit. Turn your hips forward. Be strong right here. Arms straight up. Use that back foot to help you. Lean forward. And see if you can hear the birds when you're outside. So this is warrior three. So you went from warrior one to warrior three. There is a warrior two in there. Some of my yogis might remember it. So, the bird was red. So see what red things you can find. The next pose she does is one of my favorites. She's going to go down into a squat on the ground and plant some seeds. The color that she sees is brown. So when she's down there, we call this a yogi squat. My kids, we've also called it a froggy squat. So you come back. Your feet are kind of out. You don't want them like this, a little bit out. And you go down into a squat. And maybe your squat's right here. Maybe you could go down really far. And you're going to plant your seeds. And then push yourself back up. So that's our squat. Okay, the squat pose right there. And the color was brown. Then, here's that caterpillar pose. We already did that. That's when we were in our sun A's and we came up and we went down in our bellies
Then we were down in our caterpillar pose. And this color was orange. Because you see, it's like she's a little orange caterpillar. And she can see it right there. All right. The next day, she sees bees around her. And she's sitting down in what's called a hero's pose. And then from there, she goes into a butterfly pose, where she sees the butterflies that are flying around the flowers, and that's purple. And then she's down there, and then she thinks about being a flower, and she changes her butterfly just a little bit. So I'm going to show you all three. So first was the hero pose, where she was listening for the bees. And that's just you're on your knees like this, straight down, and you sit down. So this is hero's pose. So you're just listening to the things around you. Butterfly pose is a way that we sit sometimes. Instead of crisscrossing our legs, we take our feet and we put our feet together so we have these butterfly wings. Now you can either sit with your feet really close to you if you can get your knees down, or if that's harder, you can take your feet farther out in front of you. So here's your butterfly and you fly in wings. To change it to a flower, all you do is you put your hands between your legs and lift them up, and you just kind of have your flower petals that way. So, we went through quite a few poses really fast. This is a book that Miss Tracie got on Amazon. It's a really good book. It has a lot of yoga poses in it. There's even a place in the back where you can mark some of those poses. Let me show you. There's these little charts back here. But the very last pose that Rachael does, after she's done all of these things, she's seen all the outside, she lays back on the ground like a rainbow. And this is how we always end our practice. And Miss Tracie's going to bring this down with her to the, well, I'll do it right here actually, so you can see a little bit better. But for this one, this is where you lay back, and we call it in yoga, we call it Savasana, or we call it the corpse pose, or we call it our resting pose. And at school with my yoga club, we do this as a time to do a body scan. So at the end of doing all of your yoga practice and your yoga balances and your yoga stretches or just anything that you do, it's good to just lay back on the ground like Rachael was with her arms out, her feet out. You close your eyes and you just breathe in and out like we did at the beginning. Where we breathe in for five and out for five. And when you breathe in all of the things right now that are making you happy. Maybe you're getting to hang out at home, you're spending time with your family, and those things that are kind of upsetting you, if you're not getting to be at school with your friends and your teacher, some of the things that you were going to get to do, you have to wait for a while to do them, breathe that stuff out and breathe all the good in. But how you are staying home and you're healthy and your family's healthy, and just hug on those people today. So that's what we're going to do when you lay back in your Savasana. We won't do that right now, but that's something you can do later. And then at the end of our yoga practice, we always come together and we put our hands to our heart and we say a yoga word. And the yoga word is namaste. Namaste means the light in me sees the light in you. And basically what that means, when I've talked to my kids before, is that I'm an awesome person. And you're an awesome person. So when we're together, we need to let each other know how awesome we are and how much we appreciate the people around us. So today, when you're around your family, if you get to see any friends, if you get to see friends on the computer, tell them how awesome they are. And remember how awesome you are. So put your hands to your heart. And Miss Tracie tells you namaste. And I'll see you next time.